So as I mentioned in my last video, Tesla had their Q4 earnings call last week, and they talked about the Model Y and how deliveries are going to start officially in March. They also, of course, talked about their actual earnings. So if you want to get super deep into the financials, I would recommend checking out the latest video from Ben Solins, which I'll link up here or in the description below, where he breaks down all that stuff in the numbers. But I'm going to get into more of what they talked about regarding future products. But before we go anywhere, I'm not wearing makeup, I promise. So what we're going to talk about today is what Tesla announced regarding the Model Y, the Cybertruck, Tesla Semi, Tesla Solar, and full self-driving, amongst a few other things. But first, Tesla was profitable in Q4, which is good news, and that means they were profitable for the last two quarters. Great. So we talked about how the Model Y is actually ahead of schedule, and this is really big news for Tesla because this is the first time that they're actually ahead on releasing a new product. And the Model Y isn't just coming out like one quarter early, it's technically starting deliveries in Q1, and they had originally said Q4. This is huge news for them, and it really looks good for the future because in the past, they've typically been late on a lot of their products. So if we can expect going forward that they'll hopefully at least reach the deadlines that they set for themselves, if not exceed them, that's really good. And it's especially good for the Model Y since this is the car that they said they expect to exceed sales of the Model 3, S, and X combined. For all of the new info we heard about the Model Y, you can check out my last video, which is linked up here or in the description below, and I talk about the updated range, the new wheels, and everything new we heard about the Model Y. In the meantime, I'm dying to get my Model Y, but let's talk about the Tesla Semi. So Tesla said they're going to be producing the Tesla Semi in limited quantities this year. But Elon went into specific detail talking about why exactly it's delayed. And he said, quote, "The thing we're going to be really focused on is increasing battery production capacity because that's very fundamental, because if you don't improve battery production capacity, then you end up just shifting unit volume from one product to another and haven't actually produced more electric vehicles." So battery production is obviously the most important part of producing electric cars, and we've seen this from other car manufacturers as well, like Audi, the e-tron last year was delayed due to battery shortages, and the Mercedes EQC is expecting to reach about half of the production that they had expected because of battery shortages as well. Currently, Tesla is not in a battery shortage, and that's likely because they're very aware of this issue and they're being very conscious of making sure that battery production ramps up at the same speed as the actual demand for their vehicles. But the reason this ties into the Semi is because Elon said, quote, "That's part of the reason why we have not, for example, really accelerated production of the Tesla Semi, because it does use a lot of cells." And that's lots of battery cells that they could be using in the Model 3 and the Model Y, which are really the foundation of the company's growth at this point in time. So no strict battery shortage for Tesla, but definitely delaying production of things because of batteries that they need to be focused in the Model 3 and the Model Y and other products. Luckily, back in May, Tesla actually acquired Maxwell Technologies, and there's a lot of signs pointing to the fact that they, along with what Tesla had been working on previously, are combining to have a lot of big announcements at Battery Day, which Elon said should hopefully be in April. So let's hope that Elon's time is on time this time. In the Q4 PDF report itself, they didn't really mention the Cybertruck at all except saying in development, but of course they did on the call because someone's of course going to ask a question about the Cybertruck. Elon talked about how it was crazy how the Cybertruck went viral, and he said specifically, quote, "I have never seen actually such a level of demand as this. We've never seen anything like it, basically." Regarding production of the Cybertruck itself, Elon said, quote, "We'll sell as many as we can make." And then he specifically said that, quote, "Demand is just far more than we could reasonably make in the space of, I don't know, 3 or 4 years, something like that." Now that's both encouraging and discouraging, and it's important to keep in mind that this is just Elon talking, trying to give them a little bit of information without officially announcing anything about the Cybertruck. On the one hand, when Tesla finally produces the Cybertruck, the demand is going to be far beyond what they can make. And that's a good thing because they're going to have lots of sales of that new product going on while they're still producing and selling the Model 3 and the Model Y amongst their other vehicles. On the other hand, if you ordered the single motor Cybertruck, it now says late 2022 is the release for that, and then all other trims in 2021. But Elon just said demand is more than they can make in the next 3 to 4 years. I don't want to read too much into this, and I don't think you should either, but it does kind of seem like they're going to be backed up for a while. Like, if you order a Cybertruck now, you're probably not going to get it until 2023 or 2024. But it's important to keep in mind that they haven't actually begun production of the Cybertruck, so we don't know exactly what's going to happen there. And this is just Elon predicting. He's usually late, and this car is totally different than anything they've made before. But at the same time, the Model Y is quite a bit early, 6 to 9 months early from what they originally said. But at the same time, that car is very similar to the Model 3. But regarding the design of the Cybertruck, Elon expanded and said, quote, "The product is better than people realize even. They don't have enough information to realize just the awesomeness of it. It's just great." And this is coming from a guy who's currently working on the Roadster and the Plaid Model S, so that's likely very good news for the Cybertruck. Regarding solar, Tesla said that deployment was up 26% from Q3 and that they expect it to grow by 50% in 2020. I'm excited to see Tesla's solar business ramp up because it's not as flashy as their car business, but at the same time, there's so much potential there. In the future, depending on your situation, if you're able to rent solar and then your energy bill is cheaper because you're taking a lot of the energy from the sun as opposed to an electric company, and then you're able to store that in a power wall so that you're safe during a power outage, this could be huge for the future of people's electricity. Right now, it's still pretty pricey for the average homeowner, but if Tesla can ramp up production and end up bringing costs down, I think they can really kill it in this market. And then remember, Tesla has their new solar glass product, which is Tesla solar integrated into the actual roof tiles itself. Regarding this, Elon said, quote, "It's really going to be your choice. Do you want a roof that is alive with power or dead without? And I think people will want a live roof that generates power." I couldn't agree more. If they get the cost close to the price of a normal roof, then if someone's re-roofing their house, it's going to be a no-brainer that of course I want a roof that's going to give me free energy. All right, now on to full self-driving. I was hoping that Tesla was going to announce full self-driving or release it at the time of this earnings call, but that definitely didn't happen, and so I was wrong there. What they did mention is how the latest update shows stop signs and traffic lights, and then they said, quote, "Understanding the environment around a Tesla is key to enabling our cars to react to traffic lights and stop signs and take intersections through city streets. We are currently validating this functionality before releasing to customers, and we look forward to its gradual deployment." So yeah, pretty much we're working on it with no actual release date. But Elon did expand on this idea further on Twitter, saying, quote, "Tesla will hold a super fun AI party slash hackathon at my house with the Tesla AI slash autopilot team in about 4 weeks. Invitations going out soon." So of course, this is speculation, but it does seem like if they're doing a hackathon, inviting people to try to hack this software to make sure it's safe, that it's probably pretty close to being ready. But then at the call itself, Elon expanded saying, quote, "It's looking like we might be feature complete in a few months." And then he went on to clarify that feature complete really only means that it has a chance of getting you from home to work and back. He said essentially it doesn't mean that it works well, but it works and it has a greater than 0% chance of working. Not the most encouraging words to hear, especially if you already spent $7,000 on full self-driving. So that's a little bit unfortunate there. But full self-driving is a huge thing with so much difficulty, so many obstacles, and so many safety implications involved. It's really important that they don't put it out prematurely, but I do think that going forward, they could be more clear about this and not put out timelines that they can't meet regarding software like this, especially when customers are paying for it. Yes, of course, Navigate on Autopilot, Smart Summon, and Auto Park are things that come with the full self-driving suite, so it's not like you buy it and you get nothing. And Navigate on Autopilot is pretty awesome. It's basically full self-driving on the freeway. But there are definitely plenty of people who bought full self-driving expecting city driving soon, because they said last year, coming later this year, and it's not here yet. But hopefully in the next few months, we'll see about that. For the future, Tesla laid out that their vehicle deliveries should comfortably exceed 500,000 units in 2020. Overall, my biggest takeaway from the Q4 earnings call is that Tesla is laser focused on battery production, because they know without battery production ramping up, they can't ramp up electric vehicles. Also, Model Y is ramping up and it's going to be early, so I wouldn't take this as a sign that they're going to be early on everything in the future, especially not the Cybertruck. But it's very important to look at the timeline of the Model Y and consider that for Tesla in the future. Hopefully in the future, Tesla can continue to be profitable, continue to meet their deadlines, continue to ramp up production of vehicles, and ramp up solar, along with so many other things. I think it's overall a really exciting time for Tesla. So, full self-driving in a few months? I hope so, and we'll see what the future holds. But in the meantime, make sure to like this video and also subscribe to this channel, because I ordered a Model Y and I should be getting that in a few months, hopefully. And I'll make all sorts of videos with that. So stay tuned. Thanks so much, and I'll see you on the next video.